Hello, friends. Today we're talking about a very particular nib, the Aurora Goccia nib, drop nib. It's a nib that is not very well known, and I think it's a pity, because it's really beautiful and interesting. A nib that some have sometimes talked about without knowing what the real really was, comparing it to the zoom nib of sailor and pilot. This happens because the Goccia nib is a little particular, less usual and ordinary than many others that we can find in stores, and perhaps for this reason there is an aura of mystery. How will it be done? How does it work? Is it really the copy of the zoom nib, or an emulation of the nibs of the Sailor Cross series, Naginata series, Concord, the Spatial? This is not the case, because it is a very special nib, and while I'm talking about, I scrolled through the images to see it more closely. It is a very particular nib that reveals the craftsmanship of the Aurora brand, and it is not an easy nib to make, but we will talk about this during the writing test. The Goccia nib has a shape that allows it to work from almost any angle. It is masterful finished, very nice and can probably call or recall zoom. But what is a zoom? What does it mean to zoom in? Zoom in cinematography and photography, it is nothing more than the operation of bringing an image closer from a panoramic plane to a narrower plane, vice versa. It creates a variation of the planes. As well as as a zoom nib, it is possible to bring the writing closer, making the character larger and fuller. I will show you some examples. I go from a thin line to a bold one. I just need to vary the inclination or just put in a vertical position to make it right with the tip. The beauty of this nib is that you can make it rotate also on the axis, and as long as we are positioned in the center, the nib writes like this, but as soon as we go to the tilted, the stroke increases. This fact allows us to have many styles and ways of writing available, and reaffirms the craftsmanship of Aurora brand. It is obvious that, however perfect, it is some stitching if we try to make it flow in this direction, but it is not its writing method. I write this way and it looks like an extra fine line. Now suddenly fine, and then medium. You can also write in a reverse nib mode, and this is a very high quality of workmanship is required. Now let you see the images without comment. It writes this beautiful nib simply by varying the inclination of the tip and placing it one side or the other side. See how is an ultra-fine nib when I write in reverse nib, then it becomes a fine stroke, then a medium, and finally a broad. I define up this nib as a chameleon, because it can change writing. I will show you how by varying the inclination, the line goes from thin to medium, and vice versa. In fact, due to the construction of the nib, it became possible to vary the stroke. The Goccia nib is done like this, but to understand why it's called a Goccia nib, you have to see it drawn from below. Here is the reason why it is called a Goccia nib. This nib looks like an lingot, smoothed on both sides. The support the nib is wide, and every slightest variation that we adopt while writing is performed and creates the difference in stroke. It may be a little reminiscent of the architect nib. Now I try to write with the handwriting at comics, just like an architect nib. With the writing in the capital letters, this difference in line is more evident. Now I take another notebook and I try to write in reverse nib. Unbelievable. And look, as soon as I turn it, it starts without any hesitation, without a stroke interruption. Excellent work at the nib and the power supply, the feeder, that serve even the dry side in the best possible way. Very good. Sometimes some brands ask you for an extra price for the extra fine nib, and I think that this choice is not always justified. But if I had to pay a small surcharge for a nib like this, I tell you that it's worth all the money it costs. Thanks to all friends. I look forward to see you at the next videos.